Covering Hilo to Kona, Hawaii to Na'alehu, this is Big Island Video News. I'm Stephanie Salazar. The director of Hawaii State Department of Health, Loretta Fuddy, reportedly died in a plane crash off the island of Molokai on Wednesday. News reports say Fuddy was one of nine people aboard a Makani Kai air flight that crashed about a half mile off the coast of Molokai en route to Honolulu. Fuddy was the only death. She was 65.
One of the joys of my daily existence as governor has been this remarkable lady to my right.
Parker Ranch may be able to tap into a geothermal resource somewhere on its 100,000-acre cattle ranch, according to the Pacific Business News. The Waimea-based ranch has agreed to partner with the Hawaii Institute of Geophysics and Planetology of the University of Hawaii on an ongoing study of possible geothermal resource areas and groundwater in the state. The ranch is currently developing an integrated energy resource plan to see if it's feasible to produce and provide its own renewable energy for the Waimea region. Parker Ranch CEO Dutch Kuiper presented the idea to the community a few months ago.
With these high energy prices, is there anything that we can do as a community? And it's probably the one thing that I get asked about more than anything. And I think those of you that live here, that know Waimea, that are residents of Waimea, you can just sort of turn around 360 degrees and you can see not just the natural beauty that we have, but really the significant endowment in natural resources that we have. So,
a 10 to 12 foot tiger shark is believed to be the culprit in a Wednesday morning shark attack near the popular Punalu'u Black Sand Beach in Kau. The Hawaii County Police Department says a 29-year-old Captain Cook man was bitten by a shark while bodyboarding in the area of Ninoli Bay, which is just south of Punalu'u Beach Park. The victim said he was 20 yards offshore in only 8 feet of water when the shark struck. Officers contacted the victim at Kau Hospital, where he was being treated for his non-life-threatening injuries. This is likely to be the 14th reported shark incident statewide this year. Most of the attacks have been on Maui, 8, but there have been 2 in Kona and 1 in Puna. According to the Hawaii Department of Land and Natural Resources, the state has averaged about 4 unprovoked shark incidents per year over the last 20 years, but adds that the numbers per individual year are highly variable. There were no reported incidents in 1998, just 1 in 2008. In 2012, DLNR says 10 incidents reported were at the time unprecedented. County lifeguards have posted shark warning signs at Punalu'u Beach Park, which will remain closed the rest of the day. The fire department did a helicopter flyover at 10 a.m. and was to do another on Thursday morning. DLNR says if there were no further sightings of sharks, the park would be reopened at noon on Thursday. An employee of the University of Hawaii was reportedly threatened with a gun on the Hilo campus Monday morning, and now police are asking for the public's help in locating the suspect and vehicle in the incident. Police say they received a report that a 25-year-old male employee was near the upper campus at 9 a.m. when he was accosted by a local male who allegedly brandished a firearm and pointed it at him before fleeing in a black Toyota pickup truck. The victim left the campus and went home to Puna before calling police to report the threat. He was not injured in the incident. Police describe the suspect as a local male in his 30s with a dark complexion and a neatly trimmed beard with long sideburns to his chin. He was wearing black sunglasses. The truck was described as a lifted black Toyota Tacoma with black rims and dark black tint and a white NSPYR sticker near the gas fill cover. Police advise the public not to approach the truck as the operator may be armed and is considered dangerous. Instead, anyone who has information about the case or the identity or whereabouts of the suspect or vehicle is asked to call the police department's non-emergency line at 935-3311 or contact Detective Clarence Davies. Tipsters who prefer to remain anonymous may call Crime Stoppers at 961-8300 in Hilo or 329-8181 in Kona and may be eligible for a reward of up to $1,000. Crime Stoppers is a volunteer program run by ordinary citizens who want to keep their community safe. Crime Stoppers doesn't record calls or subscribe to caller ID. All Crime Stoppers information is kept confidential.